your remix as well of Little Mix's Holiday out now. Did you ever think that you'll get that singing collaboration with the girls?
Not really even about me singing on all the songs or doing all that stuff. Like, right on that remix, I'm just doing the beats and I wanted to, like, make a whole mashup there.
Congratulations on the tune. I mean, Joel, I'll start with you really quick. I mean, you are quite literally the unluckiest guy and the luckiest guy in the world because you've got these amazing songs out, but you can't gig with them.
I know, man. I know. Literally, this is the first summer that I've, like, been back home in London. Usually, I'm like Ibiza, Zani, Malia. Like, the last 8 years of my life, I've been touring like that. But this summer, mate, I'm going to be having to smash tunes in my back garden with my mates, isn't it?
Yeah, I mean, it's been so incredible. And we've got a clip here because you performed it live for the very first time. I mean, take a listen to this. Oh, so big. I mean, Emenike, this song sounds a lot of fun to perform. I mean, how was it on the actual day, you know, kind of just doing it finally?
It was really fun. And I think it was fun to do with the Clean Bandit guys because we know them and they've always been great. I'm just excited for next year, for the time we actually do get to sing it, like, regularly. And, like, we're planning, like, bits of content where we just get to reimagine the song in a different way than the record. So... Very good.
It has been so fantastic, and the reaction to it has been wicked, hasn't it, Simon?
Yeah, it had. Mate, your voice is unbelievable. I was going to say that. That clip there didn't even do the justice of the whole thing that you did the other day.
Thank you.
Joe, I read, right, you've got to clear something up, right? Normally when people get number ones, they go out, they treat themselves to something nice and fancy, right? Now I'm told that you treated yourself to a coffee machine.
Mate, it's a fact. You know what, though? It's got, like, the proper thing that, like, whips up the milk. Oh. You know, you can deal with this mad stuff with it. So
You're really trying to sell it.
It's a good investment. I'm very happy with the coffee machine, bro.
Joel, you've got a number one record, mate. Someone else can whip your coffee for you. That's the whole thing. You become so famous that someone else does it for you.
I'm not a diva, bro. Do you know what I mean? Like, I keep it real, bro. Yeah. I whip the milk.
Yeah. I whip the milk.
A good sign about keeping it real. I whip the milk. Emenike, what about you? How did you celebrate with this record?
With friends. I did see Joel on the day, on the night that it got announced, and that was a lovely moment, and we were together and we could genuinely, like, just celebrate it and say, okay, we really did this. And it's been quite relaxed, though. That's the thing. It's hard to really, like, rage.
You got an amazing cake. Like, that cake you got was amazing, the one with the...
I've had two cakes. I've had two cakes, one for my mother, one for my boyfriend. They've both been on their baking stuff.
Can I ask, who gave you the best cake?
Don't make me do that.
Don't make me do that. No,
100%.
No, both. No. I'm sorry.
No, both. Don't both. And that's what we're going to say it as.
But mum's is always the best, isn't it?
Anyway.
Joel,
we've been following your success. I mean, you've been on a proper roll recently, and you've actually been quoted to say you're determined to be the next Calvin Harris. Have you actually met him before?
No, I've never met him before. But obviously, yeah, he's obviously a massive inspiration of mine. He's the king, isn't he? So, yeah, I mean, if I could get any success that he's had in his career, like, I'd be over the moon. But yeah, he's a legend.
I've also seen that Idris Elba, you're a big fan of Luther, and he actually played one of your songs at a festival.
Yeah, that was so sick. That was last year, because he's a sick DJ as well. And he dropped Sorry at SW4. And I was like, nah, man. I was actually watching the series as well on TV. And I was like, no way.
Oh, amazing.
I love that. I mean, Emenike, you write so many incredible songs. There are so many songs that we play here on Capital that I'm sure a lot of people had no idea that you are behind it. You know, you are the person that has come up with these incredible beats and trills and all of that type of stuff, right?
I pop up here and there.
Everywhere, mate.
Me and Sonny, we'll listen to a song sometimes and we'll just go, oh, I bet Emenike did this. And then we'll look it up and go, yeah, it did that. But, I mean, how does it feel like, you know, having that number one record and your name is there, not someone else's?
Wow. I mean, it's a very unique time. I think, like, because I released the album a couple of years ago and that really wasn't like a radio record. And so I guess like now with this, I'm now in a much more like zen point of view of just it being like, I'm just happy that people hear what I do. If I'm singing on it, if I'm like just writing, if I'm doing a little what you gonna do, like whatever it is, I'm just happy to get to do this for a living. And it means just I'm a music dude. I just do all that. And so people like it. And I'm happy to still make hits and make new friends like Joel. So
I love
it. I can't complain.
Can I just say, you referenced it there and I've got to bring that up because, so if you're listening to this now, so Jax Jones, at the beginning of his song, he always has, what you gonna do? That's M&EK.
I didn't know that. I thought it was Jax doing it.
No. Yeah, that's M&EK.
But the amount of times you had Jax in the studio, you think that was him doing that?
I'm so sorry.
M&EK, I need something for me, man. We got to make one up for me.
Yes, everyone needs the little thing.
Yeah. I love a little tag. I do my own tag.
Yeah.
Call me MNEC.
Your remix as well of Little Mix's Holiday out now. Which is massive. I mean, you've worked with the girls in the past, with On Touch, which was such a huge record. Did you ever think that you'll get that singing collaboration with the girls?
You know what? Like, because me and the girls are on the same management, and so I've worked with them across like all the albums, and it kind of goes back to what I'm saying. Like, it's not really even about me singing on all the songs or doing all that stuff. Like, right on that remix, I'm just doing the beats, and I wanted to like make it a whole mashup thing. And I've done a lot of songs on the new album, and I've been literally ad lib connoisseur on the entire album, like suggesting all the oohs and the ahs and the ho. Yeah. Like, that's my job. So
very good.
Yeah, I love getting to do it. They're great.
They love you. They like every time they come in, they do like, oh, M&EK this. Blah, blah, blah. They love it. Joel. Yeah, and we're like, all right. You haven't got him a cake yet, great. So don't worry about it. Joel, you're getting a lot of romantic DMs, I'm hearing. Now, I need to find out if there's any blue ticks coming in there.
Might be a couple.
Yeah, there is.
Give us an initial.
Yeah, there is. Yeah, give me an initial of one.
No.
An initial. First initial of one, and then I'll let you go. And then I'll let you go back to the coconut oil on the muscles.
Come on. One.
We're not going there. No, honestly, man. I've just been head down in the studio. Man's off the radar a little bit right now. But
yeah. The next time...
The DM's a little bit busy, though, I'm not going to lie.
The next time you and M&EK go into the studio, M&EK is going to be like, Joel, look up from your phone. Get off your phone, please. Yeah. Oh, dear. Hey,
well, you can enjoy. You can have a great time.
Yeah.
You just got to tell us about them, that's all.
Yeah, you just got to tell us. That was very easy. Joel, how old are you again now?
31 now, mate.
31. You're 31. But, I mean, are you looking for a settle down, or are you looking for, I don't know, you're just having fun with it?
Yeah, I was talking to my mum about this. I can't see myself getting like married for ages, or like even getting a serious girlfriend, because I'm always just so busy and
doesn't matter, mate.
Touring as well, like I just haven't got the time for it at the moment.
That's it. I mean, just absolutely live it at the moment. Both of you are absolutely smashing it.
Yeah,
all my mates are like getting married, having babies, and I'm like. Planning these big tours, I'm like, oh, I'm so far away from that.
I'm sure your mates will be very jealous of that.